So back in the late 90s, some literature started to come out, and which created quite a scare amongst women that already had silicone implants and people prospectively who were looking to get silicone. It was actually a moratorium on them. You couldn't use them. The federal government wanted to look into it a lot further. All of this was disproven, and back in about 2007, the FDA came out and said, you know what, we're going to approve. None of this was actually approved. There's no association between silicone implants and any autoimmune or any issues that were previously being associated with it. And that allowed, gave a lot of freedom back to women that are looking at implants, because the only choice they had was for saline. But for some people, silicone is really what they really want. I mean, it's more natural appearing in thin people. It really less chance of rippling. I think personally, it looks more natural, and most of my patients love it. The people that do have it, I've never had one person come back and say, "I wish I went with saline." Usually, it's the other way around. Usually, I wish I had gotten the silicone. Either one, I think that they're both great products, and it carries a very, very high satisfaction rate.